Hey there, Carrie Rhodes here. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you a card that was inspired by a challenge with Made with Love by Terry over on Instagram. She asked, what was your favorite thing? Making a card with ink blending, a shaker card with stamping, with coloring. And I said, why not a card with all four? So she took that challenge and I did too. That is how today's card came about. And I've had some stamps and dies sitting around that I've wanted to use for a long time from Dare to Be Artsy. So I'm just combining that all together for this fun shaker card. These are the stamp set and die sets that I'm going to be using from Dare to Be Artsy. It's the Christmas stamp and die set. I love their die sets. They're already snipped apart and come on a magnet sheet. And they have examples on the back. So cool. I'm also going to be using some snowflakes from the Skeezins Greetings stamp set. It also has a matching die set called the Grizzly die set. I'm going to put two of the snowflakes from Skeezins Greetings and the one snowflake from the Christmas stamp set on one block, and I'm stamping that onto a piece of Pool Play cardstock from Fun Stamper's Journey with clear pigment ink. I'll fill that up, and when I'm doing that, I'm making sure that I rotate the stamp in between stamping it, and I do have some of the snowflakes going off the side just to give it a more uniform look. And then I'll emboss that with clear embossing powder. What I'm doing is trapping this light blue color within those snowflakes. And then I'll be applying some ink over the top. So one of the parts of this challenge that I'm doing for my Instagram friend is ink blending. So I'm taking Distress Oxide ink in Salty Ocean and blending that over the top of these snowflakes. The embossed snowflake will then resist this ink, so it'll trap that light blue color and then have the darker blue color around the snowflakes. So this is the ink blending portion of my card. And then I'll take a paper towel and just buff away that ink that is sitting on top of the embossing to reveal those light blue snowflakes. And I love the look of this. It looks so, I want to say magical. Is that the right word? I don't know. I love it. And then I'll bring in my distress sprayer with water inside. I'm spraying that down where I pull the trigger about halfway down to get some of those larger splatters, and it looks like the most beautiful snowstorm. And then because I love sparkle, I'm bringing in my sparkle silk, which I use all the time. I've shaken it up to mix in that shimmer within the liquid, and then just use the applicator to splatter on beautiful shimmer on this card. So I'm loving how the background turned out. I'm going to set that aside to dry, and I'm going to stamp the little moose in the vest. It's so cute. With some jet black ink from Lawn Fawn. It's my favorite ink to use when Copic coloring. And then I'm going to color the vest. I was so excited to color this vest and make it look puffy. And I will tell you, as I say in all my videos where I Copic color, I'm not a Copic coloring expert. I'm not here to teach you how to Copic color. But what you can take away from this video is that even if you're not an expert, you can still get really good results with your alcohol markers. So I just take a couple shades, two or three of each color, and try and get some light areas and dark areas, and these markers blend together so well. It's not hard to get a good look if you have the markers that blend well together. So that can be the tricky part, but there's plenty of really awesome Copic coloring artists on Instagram, and that is what I've watched to help me learn. And I also feel like it doesn't always have to look exactly like theirs to get a good look on your card. So I'm just coloring in my mousse now with some shades of brown. I will put the marker colors up on the screen so you know exactly what colors I used. I don't have a very big collection of Copic markers, and I'm still able to get color variation and the shading that I like. So you don't have to break the bank to do Copic coloring, and there's plenty of great marker choices out there that are at different price points that you can do alcohol marker coloring with as well. And I will finish off this little guy with a warm gray marker for the white areas and the head, the part between the earmuffs. Yeah, I will do warm gray there as well, just to kind of leave it white. And then I did some B00 and B02 for the little coffee mug. So I have two different shades of blue going on as I do in my background. I'm using a colorless blender to pick up any of the little mistakes of ink that went outside the lines. I die cut my mousse, and now I'm taking a piece of Cranberry Bliss cardstock and cutting an oval shaped window for my shaker card. And then I thought it just needed a little something extra, so I am using the Pretty Plaid embossing folder to dress that up. And then I cut a wavy border using the Simply Wavy die from Lawn Fawn and some glittery cardstock for a border. And now I'm going to put my shaker card together by putting a window sheet on the back of this oval opening, and I'm putting that in place with some double stick tape. And then I'll also use the double stick tape on the front. I thought it would be the best choice with this textured paper, and that will hold my little snowy hill in place on the front of the card. And then I like to make it extra long. That way I can just come in and snip off the ends so it's flush with the edge of my cardstock. And I love the little addition of the glitter. So pretty. All right, so now I have some foam tape that I'm going to create a reservoir on the back of my card that will hold in my shaker elements. So one of the key things when making a shaker card is to make sure your foam tape touches on all four sides or wherever it meets, because you don't want any of your shaker elements to escape. So I am putting my tape right up next to each other on all of the sides. And then I'm going to put just a few little pieces in these corners just to help my card be a little bit more sturdy, and then none of my shaker elements will get trapped in those corners. Speaking of shaker elements, aren't these fabulous? They are so darn cute. They are the Winter Kiss Clay Snowflakes from Honeybee. Oh my gosh, they're so cute. I love them. So I filled my shaker card with that. I made sure none of them were stacked on top of each other. And then I'm peeling off the backing of my foam tape, and I'll put that ink blended background on to trap all those cute snowflakes and make my shaker. So just pressing that into place, making sure the foam tape adheres well with my background, and look how cute that is. I'm going to run my little mousse through my Xyron sticker maker so the back is completely covered with adhesive. I thought that would be a good choice for sticking this down onto glitter paper and a window sheet. I did have a little trouble with the feet sticking, so I did end up putting a little bit of glue under those feet and holding the feet down with an acrylic block at some point during this video. Now I'm stamping the sentiment that says Merry Christmas with clear pigment ink, and then with Huckleberry Fusion ink so that I can clear emboss that. And then I've got that light blue, dark blue look going on again for this card. So we'll heat emboss that, and then I'm going to die cut that out with some sentiment banners also from Honeybee, and that will be the perfect greeting for this card. Merry Christmas. My sister loves moose, like one of her favorite animals, so I think this card will be for her this year. So I'll put that right across the top of my oval, and then I really felt like this card needed a little embellishment, and so I'm going to bring in that medium-sized snowflake from this stamp set, the Merry Christmas stamp set, and stamp three of those with clear pigment ink on red cardstock. I'll emboss that with white powder, and then when I put these on my red background, the red border around the white snowflake doesn't really show up. It almost makes it look like these snowflakes were stamped right on that red background, even though we know that they weren't, because that's a dry embossed background with plaid. So a little fun tip there for tone on tone embossed look. I don't even know what to call that, but Here, they look really cute, and it was the exact finishing touch that I needed for this card. So I'll just glue those in place, and then I will put the whole entire panel onto a white card base that measures 4 1/4 by 11, scored at 5 1/2, and folds at the top. And that finishes off the card that has ink blending, it's a shaker card, stamping, and coloring. And I had so much fun with this challenge. And make sure that you click over to my Instagram account. You can see this card and follow me there as well. If you're new here, I would love for you to subscribe. I have new videos every week, and you can click the little bell to know when they come out. If you're interested in any of the supplies, I have them listed and linked for you below. Thank you so much for watching, and happy stamping. Bye.